It's 11 p.m. and these are tonight's headlines. The President of the Republic, Abdelmajid Tebboune, arrived this morning at Jama' al-Jazair in Al-Muhammadiyya in Algiers to perform the Eid prayer. The President of the Republic expresses his best wishes to members of the People's National Army, the National Gendarmerie Police, Civil Protection and Customs, as well as to the health sector staff. And we are sharing with you the atmosphere of Eid al-Adha abroad and in Algeria and also in the occupied Palestinian territories amid the relentless bombings. Welcome back, everyone, and sahaitkum. Today, Algerians are celebrating, just like the rest of Muslim nation across the world, the feast of Eid al-Adha. The President of the Republic, Abdelmajid Tebboune, arrived this morning at Jama' al-Jazair in Al-Muhammadiyya in Algiers to perform the Eid prayer. Welcome to the entrance of the mosque by the rector of Jama' al-Jazair, Sheikh Mohammed Ma'moun al-Qasimi al-Husayni, and the governor of Algiers. After that, the President of the Republic performed Eid al-Adha prayer in the presence of senior state officials, including the Speaker of the Council of the Nation, the Speaker of the National Assembly, the President of the Constitutional Court, the Prime Minister, the Army General Chief of Staff of the PNA, members of the government, advisors to the President of the Republic, and representatives of the Arab and Muslim Diplomatic Corps accredited to Algiers, as well as several worshippers. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah, subhanallahi wa alhamdulillah. The President of the Republic performed this morning Eid al-Adha prayer in Jama' al-Jazair, the Mosque of Algiers.
Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر السلام عليكم
And his two preachers, the rector of Jama'a al-Jazair, Sheikh Muhammad Ma'moon al-Qasimi al-Husayni, put forward the virtues of Hajj, pilgrimage, and its high significance, stressing the purpose of Eid al-Adha and what this holy day implies in terms of sacrifice, devotion, and enshrinement of the Sunnah of the Prophet Ibrahim, peace be upon him. Sheikh Muhammad Ma'moon al-Qasimi al-Husayni also recalled what's happening in the land of the prophets and the barbaric aggression against the Palestinian people and their rights by the Zionist occupation, added that there is still hope for Palestinians to recover their legitimate rights thanks to the resistance of these valiant people. Let's have a listen to his statement.
هذا يوم العاشر من ذي الحجة يوم عيد الأضحى عظم الله أمره ورفع قدره وأكرم فيه أمتنا بكرامات توجب شكره له المنة والشكر على جليل نعمه وجزيل عطاياه إن ما عاشه خليل الرحمن وابنه إسماعيل عليهما السلام من معاني الفداء والتضحية لهو سنة ماضية في الأمة المحمدية تتجسد في كل حقبة من تاريخها وكل مرحلة من مراحل وجودها وانظروا رحمكم الله إلى ما يجري اليوم في أرض الأنبياء في أرض الإسراء والمعراج في أرض فلسطين ونحن في الجزائر المجاهدة دولة وشعبا نحس بما يحسون وندرك ما يدركون من عدالة القضية واليقين بالنصر المؤزر والفتح المبين والجزائر بفضل الله كما لمت شمل الفصائل الفلسطينية بالأمس هي اليوم تسعى دون هوادة وتواصل المرافعة والدفاع عن قضيتهم العادلة في المحافل الدولية بعناية وتوجيه مباشر من السيد رئيس الجمهورية اللهم انصر إخواننا المؤمنين المستضعفين في كل مكان اللهم انصرهم في فلسطين اللهم انصرهم في غزة وفي فلسطين اللهم يا ربنا وفق ولاة أمور المسلمين في كل مكان اللهم وفقهم لهداك واجعل عملهم في رضاك اللهم ارزقهم البطانة الصالحة التي تدلهم على الخير وتعينهم عليه اللهم وفق ولي أمرنا لما تحب وترضى وخذ بناصيته للبر والتقوى برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين يا أرحم الراحمين يا رب العالمين ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم واغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولجميع المسلمين الأحياء منهم والميتين وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين.
After Eid prayer, the President of the Republic exchanged the greetings with senior state officials, representatives of the Arab and Muslim diplomatic corps accredited to Algeria as well as citizens. On this occasion, the President of the Republic presented his best wishes to members of the People's National Army, the worthy successor of the National Liberation Army across all the regions and units, including those mobilized in our borders. The President of the Republic also expressed his best wishes to all members of the National Gendarmerie, Police, Civil Protection, and Customs. And the President of the Republic also wished all doctors and medical and paramedical staff, particularly those on duty, a happy Eid. And Algerians, like all Muslims across the world, welcome to Eid al-Adha throughout the country with a joyful atmosphere, which recalls the importance of charity and compassion towards others, especially towards the most deprived ones. More details with Wanir Bahri.
On this first day of Eid al-Adha, the atmosphere was marked by serenity, which reigned across the national territory. In Tamnrast province, the faithful performed the Eid prayers in a climate of joy and tolerance.
I would like to congratulate all the Algerians and the entire Muslim community on this occasion of this celebration. We didn't forget our Palestinian brothers in our prayers. May Allah help them. To all the Muslims in the world, we pray to God Almighty to grant us the mercy, health, and safety. I send my greetings to all the Algerians. Best wishes for Eid.
It is in a highly spiritual atmosphere that the inhabitants of Wargla province welcomed Eid al-Adha, and they didn't fail to hold the gazans in their prayers on this blessed day.
Eid Mubarak to the entire Muslim community and to the Algerians in particular. We send our most sincere prayers to our Palestinian brothers. Eid Mubarak to all the Algerians. May this celebration bring joy and prosperity to our country.
The same atmosphere prevailed in the capital. After the Eid prayer, the Algerians sacrificed the sheep.
Happy Eid Day to all. I hope that all Muslims have a good Eid without forgetting our community established abroad.
Eid Mubarak to all Algerians. I hope that Eid will be synonymous with sharing and solidarity.
Eid al-Adha is an opportunity to bring together all families in an atmosphere of happiness and celebration.
And thousands of Muslims, notably from Algeria, gathered this morning for the Eid prayer at the Grand Mosque of Paris, a very special moment to remind us of the spiritual meaning of this blessed day, as reported by Afif Belouchat, taken up by Yasin Hamdi.
At dawn, the Ahlil and Takbir, our religious chants, created a special atmosphere for this first day of Eid al-Adha in Paris. Diplomatic delegations of several Muslim countries shared this blessed day with a lot of devotion and gratitude, a reminder of faith and solidarity for the unification of the Muslim community around the world.
Aujourd'hui à La Mecque, pour tous ceux qui ont participé au pèlerinage, je leur transmets.
I send my best wishes to those who accomplished their pilgrimage and to the Algerian community living in France and everywhere else in the world. I wish them a lot of happiness. A special thought to all the Muslims suffering around the globe, notably our brothers who are being bombed in Gaza. In the name of the Grand Mosque of Paris and all the working staff, we pray for all the Palestinians who are going through extremely hard times.
Traverse des moments extrêmement difficiles.
Algeria's ambassador to France and the Consul General in Paris were also present, a proof of the deep importance attached by Algeria to its community.
En cette occasion également, j'aimerais saluer.
On this occasion, I would like to salute the solidarity spirit of our community, and I call them to continue living with the values we were raised with. I also call all the Algerians to work together to continue building the new Algeria under the guidance of the President of the Republic. Happy Eid.
Pour la poursuite de l'édification de l'Algérie nouvelle sous la conduite éclairée de Monsieur le Président de la République, oyate comme ça, ça aide comme que ce n'est pas prêt.
Thousands of Algerians and their Muslim brothers from different origins listened carefully to the Imam explaining them the spiritual meaning of Eid al-Adha, thus getting closer to the heart of their beloved ones.
Happy Eid to all Algerians living abroad. A special thought to my mother on this special occasion. Eid Mubarak. May Allah accept our prayers.
And on the occasion of Eid al-Adha, a big celebration was organized at the Algerian consulate in Bordeaux, where the Algerian community celebrated the Eid in a mega barbecue with several Algerian traditional dishes, nostalgic vibes that bring back some typical Algerian atmosphere. Coverage by Afif Belhouchet, once again, commentary of Najah Tayyar.
The Algerian community abroad celebrates Eid al-Adha in a family ambience.
Eid Mubarak to you. We wish you a happy Eid every year.
In the Algerian consulate, which was decorated with the marvelous Algerian flag colors, young and old, employees, heads of enterprises, also students, all were gathered to celebrate Al-Eid together in a mega barbecue, which created an atmosphere similar to that of their homeland, Algeria.
Happy Eid to you. This is the first time in the consulate history that it hosts a barbecue gathering all categories of the Algerian community here. May God bless you all.
First, I would like to thank the council for inviting us to celebrate Al-Eid in a convivial ambience in the consulate of Bordeaux. I also thank the President of the Republic, Abdelmajid Tebboune, for letting us feel home.
The organization is perfect. Thank you. I thank the consulate for the invitation. We are having an amazing time. Happy Eid to all.
The opening of the consulate doors for the Algerian community to celebrate the happy occasions of our nation, such as Eid al-Fitr, has become a tradition established by the Algerian Council to Bordeaux. This lavish gathering was an opportunity to bring joy to all the Algerian community members who attended and to create a space to warm the hearts of those who long dearly for their homeland, Algeria.
And in New Jersey, in the United States of America, our national community rented a farm, actually, to gather hundreds of Algerians in a heartwarming atmosphere. And the Algerian vibes were definitely present, as spotted by our special envoy, Kemal Sweek. Let's watch.
We're here celebrating Eid al-Adha. We're slaughtering sheep just like we'll do in Algeria. I miss home. I'm going to go home hopefully soon. But yeah, it's a good time here, spending time with other Algerians. I'm enjoying my time here. It's nice.
We didn't see you to make it the closest thing as being in the country. We love coming to the farm. The first few years, it was an interesting experience, but clearly I love what I'm doing.
The owners are Palestinian. They gave us the land to do all the slaughtering for them. Here. And it's just been a beautiful time. The lamb are healthy. People here are healthy. And this is my dad. The kids are playing in the bouncy houses. It's a good time overall. A lot of times, Algerians don't really find a place to come together and enjoy themselves, especially during the Eid. We try to make that space available for them, and here we are.
Saha Eid kon kulam to my pay.
Saha Eid from New Jersey.
Bombings and massacres couldn't stop the brave Palestinian people from celebrating Eid al-Adha in the middle of ruins. Despite the death hunting them day and night, Palestinians showed a great determination to go through these hard times. Yasin Hamdi reports.
Early morning, the Palestinians accomplished the Eid al-Adha prayer in the middle of ruins with a lot of faith and an unwavering resilience. Despite the tragedy, they remain deeply attached to the precepts of Islam by defending with determination their land and identity.
Despite all the pain, we remain attached to our religion. We have to be optimistic for a better future.
لا شعائرنا وديننا احنا لازم نطبقه.
The restrictions imposed by the Zionist occupier couldn't stop some Palestinians from getting a sheep to sacrifice thanks to the help and support of their family and friends living abroad. But the Zionist occupation army blocked the way to the Palestinians in order to keep the Gazans from celebrating this blessed day.
For the Muslims, this day is a source of happiness because it's the occasion to make a sacrifice to God.
More than 2 million displaced Palestinians are living today in precarious conditions. They struggle every day to find food, water and medicine. They are facing poverty and famine, but they keep fighting to survive.
I don't feel any happiness today, only feel pain and grief. We lost our beloved ones, our homes and our mosques have been destroyed. Today we had to pray in the middle of the ruins of the mosques. We hope to rebuild these worship places. We'll come back stronger than ever. With the help of Allah, we'll defeat our enemies.
وإن شاء الله رح نكون متفوقين ونقهرهم إن شاء الله.
The Palestinian people may feel tired after more than 8 months of barbaric attacks. Tired, but not done. Their brave hearts strengthen their faith in Allah and make them hope for better days.
To these images we are in tonight's news. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you tomorrow. صحيحكم once again.